I'm Mike Huckman at Good Day Bio, and it is always a pleasure to welcome the winner of what's called the BioGENEius contest. And this year it is this guy, Neil Deshmukh. You are 16 years old. Congratulations. And we're joined by Seema Kumar, who is Johnson & Johnson's Vice President of Innovation Communication, and J&J sponsors the BioGENEius contest. So thank you both for being here.
Thank you for having us.
So first of all, tell us what your winning project is, Neil.
So essentially the way that I like to describe it is a AI healthcare assistant. So one big problem, especially in less fortunate areas, is the fact that there's a really weird indifference between the amount of doctors there are and the actual population. Mm-hmm. So in some areas of Asia and Africa, there's a single doctor for every 20,000 people.
Wow.
And there's no way that that single doctor can go to every one of those people, right?
So that was the problem you were solving
exactly.
for.
Exactly. Yeah. So essentially my device conducts medical analysis automatically, because you don't really need a doctor to, you know, go and gather the results for all these types of biometric data. You can have a machine and a neural network algorithm actually kind of conduct that analysis for you, and then kind of optimize it to be sent to the doctor.
So Neil, how does it work?
So
what do you do with
these
things?
I can give you a little bit of a demo, and essentially it's a 5-minute test, so it can detect four types of different kinds of anomalies. So it can do cardiac analysis, it can do dermatological or skin analysis, it can do cognitive analysis, and it can also do just general symptomatic analysis.
Wow.
And on top of that, generally what it will do after it has all those types of analyses from the patient is it will actually single out the anomalies in the data. So I can show you kind of how the setup process would be. It's fairly simple. I'm going to try putting this a little bit higher up.
Yeah. Right, so all three have to go on my arm.
Exactly. Yeah. Let's see if we can.
All these sensors.
Exactly. So I'm just going to boot this up again.
Okay.
And what each one of these is, it's an EKG lead. And what it's going to do is it's going to track the activity of your heart.
How quickly?
Actually, it's only around a 10-second test just
wow.
for the data collection. And then the other series of tests take a little bit longer, but this one is the one that actually I believe to be able to be used by these doctors really efficiently, because compared to a lot of algorithms right now, the device doesn't just say, okay, you have this disease or you don't. And it doesn't just give you raw information back, because my mom's a doctor, right? She doesn't want to look through an entire EKG signal and try to zoom in and figure out exactly where the problems are. So with this device and the algorithms, it actually identifies the anomalous portion of the EKG wave for her, mm-hmm. so that when she gets the analysis from the device,
yes.
it just says, look at this part, confirm or deny whether the algorithm is correct in its analysis.
Neil, are you sure you're 16?
I am, yeah.
Have we checked your ID? Seema, every single year, every young person comes in here who wins this contest, who competes in this contest, and they blow me away.
Absolutely. Yeah, it is just remarkable. You know, we see year after year, and this BioGENEius has been going on for 26 years. So imagine the number of innovation, the number of ideas that have come through as a result of this program.
It's so inspiring.
Very inspiring, yes.
And it doesn't stop here. So J&J isn't just focused on nurturing and fostering bright minds
yes.
like Neil's, with a $7,500 prize, I might add, for winning the contest here at Bio. But you're also looking to nurture let's say adult
yes.
scientists
Absolutely.
And entrepreneurs in your program called J-Labs. Tell us about that.
Absolutely. So, you know, great ideas can come from anywhere. And if you just keep your eyes open, you can see ideas spark from all across the world. And, you know, we are always looking for ideas, new ideas, for ways to solve healthcare challenges that we as a society face, not only here in the developed world, but all over the world, in parts of the world where we have resource infrastructure challenges. So our J-Labs facilities are incubation facilities, where there's 13 of them now, and we're launching the newest one, grand opening of it in Shanghai end of this month. And across those J-Labs in the world, as well as the innovation centers, which we have many across the world as well, we've been able to sort of create a powerful network of innovation. We're calling it the grid, because great ideas can come from anywhere, and they come from the younger generation, from the older generation, from all kinds of geographies, from all kinds of genders, all kinds of ethnicities. So if you're just open to those ideas, then those ideas can help us solve healthcare challenges of the future.
What a great program. Neil, what are the next steps for this invention? And also, I'm sure people are interested in what your plans are, if you know yet, because you're only a sophomore. So
yeah.
Do you know where you want to go to school, what you want to study, what you want to do in life?
Yeah, of course. So
now that you've accomplished all this already at age 16?
So in the future, the whole plan and goal for this device is to actually be implemented in these less fortunate areas to actually kind of make the healthcare system there more efficient, right? But one place that I'm definitely going to start with this device is I've already started talking to a few healthcare facilities. And the thing is, the way that they think that this will be most easily implementable into the market, at least in the beginning, is through insurance companies, because they have a motivation to make sure that patients stay healthy. And one term that I like to kind of throw in is the term sick care, right? Because that's kind of what we have right now. We have a healthcare system that when the patient feels sick, then you go to the doctor, right? And sometimes that's too late. When someone's having a heart attack, unfortunately, that's too late for them to go to the hospital, right? They're already having the problem. They're already having the heart attack. So with this, right, essentially the device would be, again, a 5-minute test right in someone's home, and it'd be able to tell them almost immediately before they themselves even feel any symptoms whether there is any anomaly in the data.
And is that what it's doing now? Does this show my vitals or
exactly?
Or what?
So now that we have your vitals, mm-hmm. we're just going to log out, and what we're going to do now is we're going to run the analysis.
Mm-hmm.
So we can actually just unclamp you. So that was a little bit longer, a longer sample than it usually needs.
Uh-huh.
Usually just 10 seconds is enough for the actual analysis. And once we have the your cardiac data, now we can put it into the actual algorithm, and now it's gonna start conducting the analysis. And at least for demo purposes, it's gonna give the results, right? I've had experience with doctors saying WebMD, right? That's kind of the fear where it shows the patient the results. In the actual final kind of implementation, it won't show the patient the results immediately so that they don't get scared and doesn't kind of provoke them to do anything rash, but it just sends the data directly to the doctor themselves. So they have an entire analysis of the patient. They can use it to actually, while the patient's also in the waiting room, right? That's another place where I've thought about actually implementing it, because doctors say that, you know, instead of reading a magazine in the waiting room, they can have one of these devices that the patient themselves can hook up to themselves. And when they walk in, they have more time to speak with the patient and actually have a personal connection with the patient, which is what most patients actually want. And instead of just having to do all these tests, they can actually talk to the patient on a human level.
Phenomenal. An inventor, an entrepreneur, and even a thought leader already at age 16. Seema, Neil, thank you for being here. Congratulations. And that's the latest from here at Good Day Bio.